Para navegar. repertorio que nosotros hacemos es en la parte de fiesta que se le hace a San Juan Bautista en Venezuela. O sea,
fuerte el repertorio si se requiere, pero así como tenemos un canto a San Juan Bautista muy festivo y de tambor, también tenemos nuestras piezas de reclamo de lo que está pasando en nuestro país ahorita.
So a lot of what we do has to do with partying and with celebration, and as we said during the concert, there are some songs and some genres that are specifically related to the parties of San Juan Bautista and other parties. And for these songs, you will find that they are mostly about joy and about celebration. But then there are other songs that we also play that, despite having a festive rhythm and beat, they also raise our voices about what's going on right now in Venezuela.
Yeah, that leads me to ask you, you know, we read some and hear some about Venezuela. It's in the news. And most of the stories are troubling or tragic. There's a lot of trouble. We have trouble here too, but not like what's going on there. So tell us a little bit about what we should know as Americans, as Montanans. What should we know about Venezuela that we might not know already?
Basado en lo que contestaste, es imposible no preguntarte por Venezuela, ¿no? Nosotros aquí en Estados Unidos vemos en los periódicos, vemos en las noticias, leemos entre líneas que la situación está complicada en Venezuela, pero no necesariamente entendemos por completo qué está pasando o qué no. Entonces, nosotros como norteamericanos, como montanas, como ¿qué te gustaría que supiéramos de lo que está pasando en Venezuela?
Que estamos a una distancia muy muy larga, y nosotros podemos estar disfrutando aquí, pero no nos dejamos de preocuparnos por lo que dejamos allá en Venezuela. O sea, es complicado. Queremos que la gente reconozca parte de nuestros tambores, de nuestra música afro, de nuestras costumbres, que además es lo que nos trajo para acá, pero es verdaderamente preocupante en la situación que quizás ya después que salgamos, o bien no podemos regresar, o bien si regresamos no podemos volver a salir. Así estamos, o sea, nuestra libertad está siendo truncada.
Déjame que... So we are so far away from home right now, and happy that we are here, and part of us being here has to do with being very happy about bringing these drums here and bringing the Afro-Venezuelan culture here and sharing some musical genres here. But at the same time, being distant from Venezuela, we also feel sadness about what is going on in Venezuela, and what is going on has to do with freedom and has to do with political instability. And it is so delicate what's going on, and so fragile, that we in a way leave not being 100% sure that we will be able to return, or not being 100% sure that when we return we will be able to go out again, because the situation is unstable.
Yeah. Well, for what it's worth, if there's anything we as a community can do in solidarity with you, we would like to do that, even if it's just paying attention and beyond appreciating the beauty of your music, which is astounding to us.
Lo primero que aprecian mucho la belleza de la música, y que quieren que sepan que si hay algo que ellos como comunidad aquí en Montana pueden hacer para apoyar a Venezuela, sea lo que sea, tal vez es nada más saber y decir y entender lo que está pasando, pero que quiere como manifestarse con solidaridad hacia Venezuela y sus comunidades.
Lo agradecemos muchísimo. Yo pudiera hacer un canto a capela, por ejemplo. Aquí planto mi bandera, aquí planto mi bandera para que la sople el viento, loe. Y les canto esta sirena, y les canto esta sirena de puro agradecimiento.
So, I like that. So, what she said is, based on what you just said, here I put my flag. Here I put my flag, so the wind can make it fly. And I sing you this siren song. A siren song is when the singer sings alone without drums. When the singer sings a cappella, it's called the song of the siren. And I sing you this siren song of only thankfulness. Of yeah.
Muchas gracias.
A ustedes.
Solo es cuando Guatemala, solo es cuando Rumba Macay. So I'm Chris Holmes, the executive director of the Myrna Loy, and it is our cultural center in Helena that celebrates and showcases the human spirit and the strength of the human spirit in all of its forms, music and movies and storytelling and multicultural experiences. In mid-July, right into downtown Helena, we brought an Afro-Venezuelan ensemble, the beautiful singer Betsaya Machado and her village band called La Paranda El Clavo, which is a paranda band from her village of El Clavo. It's a tiny little village of about 1,500 people. It's only an hour away from Caracas, but very rural. And what they play and sing is this very little known native Afro-Caribbean music that grew up in their area that is not even often heard in Caracas. So it's not shared widely. It's a kind of authentic world music from this place that almost never gets to be shared outside their village. They had a very successful tour across Canada last year. This year they went to Global Fest 2017 in New York City, and they absolutely took the place by storm. they got featured in the New York Times and on NPR. And so out of that, they were signed up with this program called Southern Exposure, which is a grant program administered by the New England Federation, New England Foundation of the Arts. And Southern Exposure brings artists from Latin and South America up to do tours of the United States. They were on this roster, and the Myrna Loy Center is a longtime participant in this grant program. So I heard about them, and I said, little tiny village in Venezuela, little tiny village in Helena, we have to share this music together. We have to find out what life is like for them as people and share our lives, even for a day, as people with this wonderful ensemble. The Myrna is really an arts instigator in the sense that we don't just present performers or show films, but we also like to drag our performers down to the Hub Coffee patio and engage kids and the Grand Street actors in coming in and learning how to dance and exchange activities and music and joy and build relationships. And those participants in the little dance lesson that we did today, some of those children will go home and listen to that Venezuelan music, and they'll start repeating some of those dances that they learned. And we have created connections across the globe just by this little spark of arts activity in downtown, which is the coolest thing about being able to bring these guys into town.